Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be all about week 29 in this pregnancy. As of today, I am 30 weeks and 1 day pregnant. So this video is gonna talk about week 29 as a whole for me. So let's get right into it. My week 29 baby is as big as an acorn squash, weighing at about 2.5 pounds and 15.2 inches long. The app talks about, which is the Bump app, by the way, I'm always using this one for my facts. It's just talking about how baby's getting cramped, therefore you're feeling a lot more movement because baby's trying to get more comfortable, and just makes it easier to feel movement at that point. Baby is growing white fat deposits under his skin and his energy is surging because of it. That I did not know, and that makes a lot of sense because he doesn't stop ever. By this point, baby is only a third of the weight that he is predicted to be by birth. This says that baby will triple his weight before birth, which is wild. The app just kind of tells you that you can kind of figure out baby's personality at this point. And I recently said this in an Insta story, I think it was, or maybe it was a video, I don't remember. But I talked a little bit about how it is true that I feel like at this point in gestation, baby already kind of has like a personality. You kind of know what time of day they're like playing or sleeping or just like, you know, stuff like that. And you can kind of get a sense of like who they are a little bit. And it's really cool because only you have that. And that's really special. So the app also says that as baby continues to grow, he's putting pressure on the digestive system, which effects of that could be hemorrhoids, heartburn, pelvic pain, and frequent urination, all of which I have experienced. By now, baby is already having dreams, which is so cool. And I can't help but think of the movie Look Who's Talking. When I hear stuff like this, it honestly makes me laugh. Like, the fact that they can't really dream of anything besides what they know already is really cool. Like, who really knows what they're dreaming about, but they're dreaming. Baby is practicing breathing by moving his diaphragm. Now's about the time that you will be told to do kick counts. Now, I don't go back to the doctors for another couple weeks, but if I remember correctly from my previous pregnancy, I think it's like you want to feel 10 kicks per hour or something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments down below. I'll obviously hear more about it at my next appointment, but I think that's roughly correct. Now to get more personal, all of my actual symptoms. I'm gonna say one thing, I'm gonna switch things up a little bit, and when I talk about my pregnancy weight gain, I have been giving out a number. I'm noticing that for myself and my fragile psyche, hearing a number and sharing a number is starting to make me a little bit uncomfortable. At this point, I just feel more comfortable sharing a total weight gain. If you are new here, I weighed myself the day I got my positive pregnancy test at about 4 weeks pregnant. I am 30 weeks and 1 day today, and I am weighing myself every Wednesday morning because that is when I am doing these updates for you guys. And as of this morning, I have officially gained a total of 14 pounds since the beginning of this pregnancy. I'm roughly gaining about a pound a week, it seems, which is about a half a pound more than what is kind of like expected. But I'm not totally mad, just because if I continue to gain a pound a week for the next 8 to 10 weeks, I'm going to meet my goal of 25 pounds. This pregnancy gained, I'm okay with gaining 30. I'm hoping not to gain any more than that. So at 30 weeks, gaining 14 pounds, I'm not really mad at. So as you can see, and as you will see in all of my videos to come, and I keep talking about, I am out of breath all the time. Even just talking takes way too much breath out of me. My hip pain. So my left hip bothered me with my firstborn Maverick, and it bothered me, I want to say, probably from now until the end of pregnancy, and then he is a few months past 2 years old, and sometimes I still would get, before pregnancy, I would get like a pain in that hip if I was sitting too long or driving too long, if I slept funny. But that hip pain has officially come back, and it is there pretty much all the time. Week 29, I am kind of an emotional wreck. Ugh, I'm having so much trouble keeping a level head about a lot of things, and I'm noticing that things that would normally make me angry are making me sad, and I am just like a ball baby over like just everything lately, and it's really hard to deal with, especially when you take care of your kids all day. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I only have one right now here, but he is, you know, a two-year-old, and sometimes it could just be really overwhelming. And I feel like the fact that I am as pregnant as I am is making it as overwhelming as it is. So as well, in week 29, my appetite has lessened, thank goodness. I feel like I still have days here and there where I can eat like all day long and it's like never enough. And I don't beat myself up about it. I know, and just to let anybody know who doesn't, 9 times out of 10, if you are not normally hungry all the time and you have days here and there, or even like a week at a time here and there where you are just starving and can't get enough food, baby is growing, baby is asking for that food. Don't beat yourself up about eating more than you did the day before or the week before. Just, you know, try to make the best choices as always. At this point, my appetite has lessened. I don't have to eat quite as much to fill myself. I'm finding it easier to stay away from binging because I'm not eating as much. My belly is also getting full a little bit faster, and I feel like that's because this child is constantly pushing up against my diaphragm and my stomach. And okay, so as well in week 29, I'm starting to become easily overheated. This is the same thing that happened with my son. Granted, thank God it is not the middle of summer like it was for my firstborn. With this baby, however, I live in the Northeast, and as of right now, winter weather is pretty much happening. It's pretty cold, obviously something I am native to, so it's not the worst, but at night especially, I am noticing that, you know, we have the heat on, but I have to have the fan on, and sometimes I wake up and I am literally just hot. I'm throwing the blanket off of me. There was one night in particular in week 29 where I woke up literally drenched in sweat and like felt my heart racing. I don't even remember like if I was having a dream or what, but like I just remember I got up, I went pee, I came back to bed, I put shorts on, and I just laid there with the fan on and nothing over me until I cooled down and then was able to go back to sleep. But definitely becoming warmer, which again is something that's normal due to heavier blood flow and all that good stuff. Okay, in week 29 as well, I think I experienced Braxton Hicks. I never experienced Braxton Hicks with my firstborn, and I still don't really know if I did. The only way I can describe what I felt, and it was 2 or 3 times in one day, and it was like sporadic, was just my belly just got tight, just all the way around, and like in the middle of my belly, not real low, it was like where my belly button is, and like that whole, like, you know, plane across, just got really tight for a good like 38, 40 some odd seconds, and then would go away. It wasn't painful, and I was having trouble deciphering whether or not it was something like Braxton Hicks or it was baby pushing his butt out, because he does that a lot. But the fact that it was kind of like the whole length of my belly left and right, but I don't know. I feel like a lot of times I hear people describe Braxton Hicks as like being pretty painful or uncomfortable. And I mean, it wasn't fun, but like I wasn't in discomfort, I wasn't in pain, so I'm not really sure exactly what that was, but totally not uncommon though. I was warned in my last doctor's appointment, where, what was that, like 2 weeks ago now, I think? Jiminy Crickets. She told me to just start to prepare for, like, I will feel contractions here and there because I'm just at the point of pregnancy where my body's just going to be getting set, wanting baby to get set for delivery. So okay, the moment we've all been waiting for. This is going to be a little bit lengthy because I need to explain this whole thing to you guys, because I don't know if it's noticeable at all, but I am not in like the best of spirits. I'm actually a little bit annoyed and just like confused. You guys saw, if you didn't, I failed my 1 hour glucose test by 10 points. I went back for my 3 hour glucose test this past Monday, 2 days ago. I'm not gonna go into details about how it went. Long story short, it was not pleasant. My body sitting on and processing 100 grams of sugar on an empty stomach was not fun for me. I got my results back, and I'm going to pop pictures here to explain something to you guys, and just like, I want your honest opinions on this. Now, first of all, I wanna say, the first phlebotomist, that's such a hard word for me to say, I put the L in the wrong spot. The first phlebotomist that I saw that day, when I told her what my reading was for my 1 hour, I was 10 points off. Every hospital, every practice is different in what they look for, apparently. Mine looked for, I don't necessarily know exactly what they, it's MG/DL. I'm not sure what that stands for. I could look it up, I don't feel like it right now. But the number that is given was they wanted to see a 135 or less. Mine at the 1 hour glucose test was a 145. When I mentioned this to the phlebotomist, she gave me a look and straight out said to me, I don't know why you're here doing this, because that's pretty much just borderline. And it was ridiculous to her that I was there to do a 3 hour with that reading. And long story short, we sat there and talked for a little bit, and she basically told me that she believes that if I were to have fasted, which they do not mandate, they don't even like suggest it to you. It's not recommended, but it's not mandated. And you don't have to, according to them. So I didn't, and she pretty much told me if I had fasted that morning, I probably would have passed it. Anyhow, I was annoyed off the bat because I was really honestly like nervous to do this, whatever, blah, blah, blah. So I did it, it was done. But now, I actually literally just got a phone call 30 minutes ago because I have my online patient portal where I received the results yesterday that I read here that I will share with you guys. And then I received a phone call today. So I'm gonna tell you what the phone call was first before I read this to you. The phone call that I received a half hour ago was the receptionist telling me that the midwife who read my results is saying that I am borderline gestational diabetic and that she recommends that I see a nutritionist, which I kindly declined because I don't see at all. Now, I am not a health practitioner, but I think this is pretty common knowledge when you read something like this in black and white in front of you, that I am not borderline gestational diabetic. So it's really frustrating. I'm not gonna go and talk to a nutritionist, and I'll show you guys why in a minute. But I'll just tell you right now, the only thing that is frustrating is because I know I'm gonna go and see my doctor in a couple weeks and get bullied. And like, I just hate when they do that. Like, she's gonna talk to me as if I don't know how to read numbers. And it's going to bother me. So I will tell you guys right now how I am not borderline gestational diabetic. Now, number one as well, I wanna mention, because I was so nervous about this, I was watching countless videos on people's 3-hour glucose tests. In these videos, in my own research, in people that I've talked to, everyone pretty much told me that you get 4 blood draw readings, your first one being your fasting one, then you drink 100 grams of sugar, and then hour 1, 2, and 3, blood, 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 reading, reading, reading. And each reading has a different exceptional number or less or whatever. So there was a few people in particular that were very specific in their descriptions and mentioned how they were pretty much told, which I wasn't really explained anything, they were pretty much told that you have to pass 2 out of 3 readings to be considered passing, and you don't have to worry about a diabetic diet or anything like that. Okay, keep that in mind. So like I said, I'm gonna pop it here. As you guys can see, the standard range for the fasted glucose reading is 93 or less. My reading was an 84, so perfectly fine, right? Okay, so let's go to hour number 1. Now remember this, okay? Remember this very clearly. When I went to the 1-hour test, I drank 50 grams of sugar, not 100, 50, and I was 10 points over. This is at 1 hour where I fasted for 10 hours prior, but 100 grams of sugar consumed, okay? The standard range is 180 or less. My reading was 157. So significantly less than what is even acceptable at the highest range, okay? At the 2nd hour, the standard range is 154 or less. My reading did not move. I stayed between hour 1 and 2 at a 157. Okay, 3 points over. So as I'm reading this yesterday, when I opened this up, I was like, oh God, like what was hour 3? Because now I'm panicking. You know, you fail 2 out of 3, then you fail and that's it. Now we go to the 3rd and final hour. The standard range is 140 or less, and my reading was at 118. Significantly less than even the highest standard acceptable range. So someone please explain to me how the doctor can look at me and say I am borderline gestational diabetic. I'm not going to waste my time going to a nutritionist to tell me to do all the things that I'm already doing when I clearly passed the glucose test. I'm just very frustrated, and especially because, I don't know if I already mentioned this, but the phlebotomist also, when I went to this test, mentioned to me that she wholeheartedly believes when she sees women that come in for the 3-hour and they just barely failed their 1 hour, she 100% felt that they do it in a manner so that you fail your 1st hour and you have to come back and your insurance will be charged for the 3-hour test. Granted, no charge to me, but I'm not going to bother them having to charge my insurance for a nutritionist that I don't need. So I may seem a bit overdramatic. Like I said, I am overdramatic. I've been seriously emotional lately, but it honestly is frustrating because I hate when doctors use scare tactics, especially when it's for nothing, because any half intellectual person could read those numbers and see that it doesn't make any sense to say that I am borderline gestational diabetic when I clearly passed. Because I borderline failed for the 2nd hour, but hours 1 and 3 were far from failing, how you can say, I just don't know. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Like I said, I'm not a doctor. I probably sound ignorant to some people, but that's honestly just my outlook on it. Either way, I 100% am looking at it as I passed. Those numbers look damn good to me. So that's that. I passed my 3-hour glucose test and that's it. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys my bump. And that is it for today's video. Please leave comments down below on just kind of what your take on this whole situation is. And even that aside, how are you guys feeling at this point in pregnancy? If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, please hit subscribe if you are new and hit that notification bell so you never miss when I post a video. PSA, I will be revealing baby's name, and I know I keep saying this, but I have officially figured out what I want to do. I talked more in depth about it on my Instagram, which is always linked down below. I'm trying to keep you guys up to date on my Insta story, so go ahead and follow me if you don't. But I have an idea, finally, of what I want to do to reveal baby's name. And as long as all goes well, I will be able to record that this weekend. And I do not want to go to bed Sunday night unless this video is edited and ready to post Monday morning to share baby number two's name with you all. So make sure you are subscribed and your notification bell is on for all videos, and you guys won't miss that. As always, I hope you're all enjoying your day, night, afternoon, whatever time it is, wherever you are, and I will see you guys very soon in my next one. Bye.